We studied with regards to Hijrah.
Yeah.
Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab said with regards to Hijrah, obviously with Dalil. What does that mean to us who have been born in the United Kingdom, grown up in the United Kingdom? This is our country where we live. What is the guidance to us?
قلت بمسألة الهجرة الوجوب ومثل هذا فكيف ماذا يعني هذا لنا الذين ولدنا في بريطانيا ونشأنا في بريطانيا وإحنا من مواطن بريطانيين مثلا
أول شيء الهجرة ليست مسألة يعني من محمد بن عبد الوهاب الهجرة مسألة مقررة في الشريعة بجميع علماء الإسلام جميع المذاهب الأربعة تقول بهذه المسألة
The first thing is that hijrah or migration isn't something which is only mentioned by Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. It's something which is affirmed and mentioned by all of the madahib and all of the ulama of fiqh, because something which is mentioned obviously in the Quran and the Sunnah.
Well, hijrah bayyana al-maqsud minha wa huwa an yaslama deenul muslim min al-ridda an islam aw al-dha'f fi al-tamassuk bid-deen.
And we clarified that the objective or the aim of hijrah is that a person safeguards his religion and safeguards himself from apostasy, from being, you know, apostating from the religion as a result of the error. So that's the objective of hijrah.
تسمعون عن بعض الجاليات التي هاجرت من تركيا إلى ألمانيا أو من لبنان إلى الأرجنتين. الآن أحفادهم لا يعرفون شيئا من الإسلام.
Yeah. So you hear, for example, some incidents where, you know, Muslim families migrated from, for example, Turkey, to Germany or from Libya to Argentina and their grandchildren they know nothing at all whatsoever about Islam.
هل هذا يجوز لآبائهم?
Is this permissible for on their fathers? Is this allowed for their fathers to do that?
ما السبب?
What's the reason?
أنهم لم يظهروا دينهم وتساهلوا حتى ذاب الأولاد في المجتمع.
The reason is that they didn't show their religion, i.e. they didn't outwardly practice their religion. So as a result of that, gradually they melted into society basically because they didn't practice and show outwardly their religion, their identity.
ولهذا الذين أظهروا دينهم وحافظوا عليه وحافظوا على أولادهم بقوا متمسكين.
So that's why those that show their identity, I have their Islamic identity and practice their religion outwardly, they're the ones who safeguard the religion and safeguard the religion of their children, inshallah, by the permission of Allah.
ونجد ما شاء الله بعض إخواننا من المقيمين هنا أو المولودين لا زالوا محافظين حفاظا شديدا على تعلم اللغة العربية تعلم القرآن ومحافظة على الصلاة وهذا شيء بحفظ يجعل الهجرة بالنسبة لهم مستحبة وليست واجبة.
So you'll find people in here in the UK, or the Sheikh said that he's seen people here in the UK who they safeguard and they have their Islamic identity, they safeguard, they preserve their religion, their children, they teach them Arabic, they teach them how to pray. And in their case, making hijrah is mustahab, it isn't something which is wajib.
فهذا التفصيل يعني في يختلف من شخص إلى شخص من بلد إلى بلد. So أحيانا إذا رجع إلى بلده قد يقتل ولا يجد مكانا يؤويه فيكون معذورا.
So basically it differs from person to person, from country to country. It might be a case if a person goes back to his country, they're going to kill him. So he's excused from leaving where he is and leaving his country, which may be a Muslim country. So in other words, the ruling differs from person to person and from place to place and individual to individual.
Are you struggling to find an organized way of studying? Too many webinars and no direct study route? Well, why not study with Madinah College online? Starting your journey is easy. With a simple registration system, you'll be studying in no time. To find out more, visit www.mclportal.com and sign up today.